Hi, this is Eddie from Switzerland with another knife video, and today we're going to take a look at a new knife from Mazarin, which is an Italian company very much alike to Fox Knife, Lion Steel, Viper, and so on, all the other Maniago based companies that you know out of Italy. But it's one of the lesser known companies, and I try to feature them on my channel because I think they do some great work, have some interesting and very underappreciated models in their lineup. And here I have an evolution of a knife that I have reviewed in the past. In the past, I reviewed the Mazarin Police, which was designed by the same designer as this one right here, and was a knife that I really liked. It was a larger tactical style knife, but I really liked the design, and I thought this was a really good design. And here they came out with another even larger tactical folder from the same designer. And the knife we're going to talk about today is going to be the Mazarin Reactor. And here we have it, very much reminiscent of the Police, but in a larger form factor and with some different design cues. The design is made by Nikolai Lilin. His nickname is Colima, and here you can see his a little bit changed logo, which looks very nice and aggressive right there. Nikolai Lilin is a Russian Special Forces soldier that also does some fictional writing and some writing about his experience as a soldier in the Italian language, and so is a well-known writer in Italy. And this is a design that they built with him, as well as the Police was. And if you're interested in the Police, check out the link in the top right corner to see my Mazarin Police video to get all the information there, because there are certainly some similarities on these two knives. So this is the Mazarin Reactor, and it is certainly a very large tactical folder. You can see I have small to medium hands, 7.5 sterile glove, and you can see I can fit 2.5 hands on this handle here on the Reactor. So certainly a large full-size tactical folder with a titanium frame lock, deep carry pocket clip, running on bearings, and the steel is D2 on the blade right here. You also have your opening groove or blood groove, however you want to call it. It can also be used to deploy the blade very easily. You saw the spidey flick is possible here to open this knife. You can also open it with your thumb, slowly and controlled, and can even flick it open with the thumb using the blood groove or opening groove. Right here we have a stonewashed blade finish, G10 show scale with a filler tab here for your swappable deep carry pocket clip, tip up left or right side, standoff and a backspacer in the back, a stainless steel glass breaker, which is a little bit blunt. I'm not quite sure if that actually would work as a glass breaker, but certainly as an impact point. We have some nice milling on the titanium as well as the G10. And now let's take a look at the specs of this knife. You also have a stainless steel lock bar insert with over travel stop. So the Reactor by Mazarin is certainly a very large knife. I'm going to tell you the specs right now. We have an overall length of 9.65 inches or 24.5 centimeters, which gives us a blade length on the Reactor of 4.33 inches or 10.5 centimeters. We have a blade stock of 3.2 millimeters of D2 steel blade. We have a flat grind that runs from about 3/4 of the height of the blade up, and it terminates in a very sharp and quite thin, actually, cutting edge here on this large over 4-inch blade. Then we have a hand length of 5.5 inches or 14 centimeters. You saw before, this is certainly a lot of room, even if you have extra large hands. And the weight of the Reactor here comes in at 162 grams or 5.7 ounces, which is certainly also a hefty weight. Overall, we have some skeletonization to keep the weight down a little bit here on the titanium frame lock side, as well as the G10. But of course, to balance the blade out, because you have a very large and heavy forward blade, they opted to put in a stainless steel backspacer, so you actually have a good balance point where you have your finger grooves right here. So I think the balance point would be right there on your little groove, and that is quite well done. It also feels very nimble and easy to move in hand, even though it's quite a large blade. Blade to handle ratio is also executed quite well. You can see they don't have a lot of room wasted here in the handle back there, so they really put everything they could inside this blade. You can also see the action is very, very smooth and free falling, as you can see right here. All the opening methods work great, and the blade is very, very smooth. But because you have a very large, long, and heavy blade, and the detent is not super strong, it works every time to deploy the blade, but it's not extremely strong, so you can half ass it if you want to. You can also shake the blade out of the handle. Now, because this is concept of this knife is a tactical folder, maybe that was intended to be that way, but you just have to be careful not to have it open up in your pocket like this when you're carrying it tip up. But it's not that easy to shake it out. You really need a dedicated thwack to really throw it out there, but that is certainly something you should keep in mind, that the detent is not overly strong, but deployment works great with all the different methods I have shown you. And you can shake it open if that was intended, I cannot tell you. Overall, looks wise, it looks very gorgeous in my opinion. Of course, for an EDC blade, for me, it's quite a bit too large, so not going to be something that I would carry on an EDC basis. But as a tactical folder, I think size and reach is something you would like to have. But as I said before, I'm certainly not a knife fighter or a tactical expert on these things, but I think this is certainly an interpretation of a tactical knife that could do you some benefits if you had actually to use this to defend your life. You also have some nice milling lines here on your titanium frame lock, as well as on the G10. Provides a good amount of traction, providing also with your nice forward finger guard that will be made when you deploy the blade out of the pretty large flipper tab right here, that is actually quite far back behind the pivot point. So normally you would like to have the flipper tab right on your axis that you would turn the blade, but this is actually quite far back, but still works very well. So they really have dialed in that pivot point really nicely. It runs on captured stainless steel bearings, and here you can also see your massive stop pin. No stainless steel liner on the G10 right there, but G10 is quite a strong material, so I'm not in any way discouraged from the stability of this knife. There's absolutely no play in any direction. You also have your stainless steel lock bar insert, some jimping to aid you in the disengaging of the frame lock there. No stick, because you have the stainless insert. Very easy to deploy. Very well executed sharpening choil right there. Nice and large stonewashed finish. Nice blood groove or opening notch, which really gives this knife quite a bit of character. Looks absolutely gorgeous here. The blade, you have the Mazarin marking, steel and Italy. And on this side, you have seen, you have the Colima design and the Colima logo right there. Also decorative pivot screw and the pocket clip filler tab, as well as the pocket clip. The pocket clip works great because it's a long pocket clip, so it's very easy to get over thicker pants. You have quite a bit of clearance there. It's also not too obtrusive. You don't get any problem in the hand. No hotspot, even if you give it way back, so you really have contact with your pocket clip. You certainly can feel it, but it doesn't issue any kind of hotspot problem. If you keep it forward like I would do, you have some jimping here on the flipper tab, on the spine of the blade, as well as on the handle. Some nice, sharp, fine jimps here on the handle that actually really do some good work in terms of traction. Also, the tip is quite robust, but still nice and piercing. And the cutting edge is also done very nice and symmetrically. And you got quite a bit of cutting edge here on the reactor. Now, let's take a look at the size comparison I do here on the channel. As always, first off, I have the Shurigorov F95NL, which is the largest knife I have in the collection, and you can see it is quite a bit smaller than the reactor by Mazarin. Blade length wise, you can see they are actually quite close. If I a little bit larger on the Kalima, but not by much. So very close in the blade length of the F95 NL here. Hand length wise, it's going to be a little bit larger. Thickness wise, it's actually quite a slender overall folder for its size. You can see pretty much the same as an F95 NL. And then to complete the Shirogorov sandwich, I have the Neon Zero, which is going to be quite a bit smaller than the Reactor. You can see that right here. Then I have our Benchmark EDC blades, Para 3 with the aftermarket scale by Sharp Dressed Knives, and the Allen Putnam scaled Benchmade Bugeye, both quite a bit smaller overall. The Spyderco is also always a good reference for a handle thickness, and you can see those two are also quite similar there. And of course, blade stock thickness will be different, thicker on the Reactor. And the only other thing I have to compare it to, because as I said before, I don't own a lot of large blades like this one here, is the Chris Reeve Umnumzahn, also a very well-known blade. So I think this could help you sort out the size of the Reactor, and you can see it's quite a bit larger than an Umnumzahn. Blade length or cutting edge wise, it's going to be larger than an Umnumzahn as well. Also, amazing knife, the Umnumzahn, certainly one of my favorite Chris Reeve knives and one of my favorite knives in this price category. Absolutely gorgeous blade, the Umnumzahn by Chris Reeve. So I hope you could get a feel for the size of the Reactor right here. Certainly a big one for sure, and not something I would carry for EDC, but for outdoor carry, for actual tactical use carry, if you're in the military and searching for something like this that has a deep carry clip, so it's not obtrusive, you're not going to lose it by falling out of your pocket, you still got a multitude of opening methods. You can of course also use it two-handed with your thumb, Spidey flick it, Spidey drop it of course as well, because you have that opening notch right here, flipper tab, which also works great as your finger guard if you actually have to use it in a tactical thrusting motion. So overall, I think very nicely thought through concept here, and if I needed a large blade like this, I think the Reactor was one of my top choices. Price wise here, the Mazarine Reactor is coming in at $180 with the D2 blade, titanium frame lock bearing, stainless steel insert, G10 lock side. And I think the size range that they went for here of over 4 inches, but still manageable thickness and a good deep carry clip, are all features that make this a very compelling tactical folder, especially if you're a police officer and you want to carry something that is not going to totally show off every time you have it in your pocket. I think this would be a great knife to carry for a police officer, in my opinion. But as I said, I'm not an expert, but I think for tactical use, or if you just want to have a large beefy folder on your EDC carry because you're a large dude and you do a lot of stuff in the outdoors, I think this could serve you very well. But it has D2 steel, so you have to keep it oiled up or just take care of your blade, so you're not going to have this large chunk of steel rusting on you, but you will have some good edge retention here from this D2 steel. I think for a large blade like this, D2 is certainly a good and tough choice for this knife. So this was my video about the Mazarine Knives Reactor. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section below, and I will answer there as soon as possible. And if you want to see more of this knife content, please follow me here on YouTube and on Instagram at 7ready_knives_reviews. And if you want to get your own knives, please check out whitemountainknives.com and use my discount code 7ready to get yourself your own knife of choice and to support the channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.